Rachel Parsons is the media liaison with the NRA, and we've been discussing the NRA not just because of the gun cases that have been coming before the courts, but also with the news concerning the DISCLOSE Act, which passed the House. We had two Republicans voting for this DISCLOSE Act. Rachel, good afternoon, and thanks so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
First of all, I want to start because I understand that this is such a hot button issue right now, and I have read so much about this online. I know some people are upset. But first, what I want to sort of get with here is I want to acknowledge that the NRA has done fantastic work in upholding the Second Amendment. And had it not been for the NRA, that I think that it would have been eradicated long ago. And I appreciate the NRA's involvement with the ruling that we just got with the Chicago handgun ban. What have you been hearing personally from people who have been reaching out to the NRA about this?
Sure. Well, I think when the news first came out that the NRA would not be included in this bill, I think that people were very unhappy and they were upset because it did get reported that we made backdoor deals with the Democratic leadership, which was not actually true. Mm-hmm. But once we have an opportunity to explain our side of the story, I think a lot of people have come around to actually agree with us in our move to just back off this bill, which did not mean that we supported it at all. It's actually an egregious attack on the First Amendment for political speech, and we think that any kind of restrictions on political speech is a terrible thing in this country because we believe that people deserve the right to speak out, whether for or against a politician.
Mm-hmm.
With that being said, if this bill had gone on, and it is going on to the Senate, including the NRA, it would have completely put a gag order on our speech during elections, and it would threaten our members' right to privacy and freedom of this association. So it would have forced us to turn over our donor list and our membership roles over to the federal government, which is obviously something that we protect very closely because we don't release the information of our members at all.
Yeah. One of you may know Eric Erickson, who does Red State. He and several other people were very angry about this. He, in fact, wrote that this isn't so much about a rights issue as he looks at it as this is about the NRA not wanting competition from other groups. And he writes, why not encourage others to fight, collaborating with the left to shut down competition? How do you respond to something stated like that?
Well, the National Rifle Association is the strongest voice for the Second Amendment on Capitol Hill and in state and local governments. You know, obviously, all the pro-gun rights groups are great for this movement. However, the National Rifle Association, matter-of-factly, is the largest, most influential voice for the Second Amendment on Capitol Hill. If our political speech were to be restricted, we would no longer be able to protect the Second Amendment. We would no longer be able to be a voice on Capitol Hill. And we are a nonpartisan, single-issue organization. And our number one priority is to the Second Amendment. It would have been irresponsible of us, because we have a sworn duty to protect the Second Amendment, to press forward on this particular issue. Let's look at the facts. Back in 2002, when McCain-Feingold was coming up, mm-hmm. it was a Republican-led Congress. It was a Republican president. We fought tooth and nail to keep that bill from moving forward, and it still went.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So that was, we could not take that chance again. We couldn't risk our speech. We couldn't risk the privacy of our members because that is our number one priority.
Yes. And I do realize, too, that, and I'm not, I consider myself a very, very conservative independent. And I also look at Democrats and Republicans, too. When it comes down to Second Amendment rights, more often than not, Republicans have fallen on the right of that. But I was looking at the statement that the NRA set out, and I understand where you say that our responsibility is to protect and defend the interest of our members. But I think, too, that the members of the NRA, of which I am one, my husband is, so is every single, most of the members of my family who aren't Democrats, God help them. We're all members of the NRA, and we all have other interests besides the Second Amendment. And I sort of look at this as though we either all stand together or we hang separately. Did the NRA try to include any other groups before going forward and pushing for an exemption to protect groups that perhaps stand up for other rights, as you mentioned, other interests in the statement that the NRA sent out?
Sure. Well, of course, we all have our own political standings beyond the Second Amendment, but the NRA is so strong because we have always remained faithful to the Second Amendment and faithful to those politicians who protect the Second Amendment, whether they are, regardless of the side of the aisle they vote on. And that's why we're so, that's why we have so much credibility on Capitol Hill. And if we started to go over into other freedoms, then we wouldn't be as powerful on the Second Amendment. And also, I want to point out that there are other organizations out there who have lobbyists on Capitol Hill. And they should be fighting for their interest. But we had to fight for our interest. We had to fight for the Second Amendment because we have so many people who are standing on the sidelines ready to attack at any moment on the Second Amendment. Every single session of Congress, we're fighting assault weapons bans. We're also fighting court battles, which we had a great victory today with McDonald versus the city of Chicago. Mm-hmm. And also, we are fighting attacks from the UN. So if we are not able to speak and communicate to our members and to the American public when it comes down to election time, then we are at risk of losing what we have worked so hard to maintain, which is the Second Amendment in this country. So, as far as this Disclose Act goes, we don't support the bill. We just backed off because now we're no longer affected by it, which we think is great news, and we don't apologize for putting the Second Amendment above all else and our members' privacy.
Yes. Well, I still think that it worries me as a member and someone who works in the realm of free speech that who would be left to defend the NRA once everyone else is gagged?
I'm sorry, could you repeat that again?
I just wonder who would be left to speak out for the NRA or for Second Amendments besides the NRA if everyone else is gagged under the Disclose Act?
You're absolutely right. We think this is an egregious bill. We told Congress on May 26th, prior to the exclusion, that we would strongly oppose this bill because we don't believe that there is any reason for restrictions on political speech. And we had to, while it wasn't an easy decision to make, we had to put the Second Amendment over the First Amendment. We had to say that.
So you believe that
We protect the Second Amendment, and there are other organizations who lobby Congress who must protect the First Amendment, but we cannot lose our First Amendment freedoms to communicate with our members.
Yeah. Do you think that all rights are equal, or do you think that some, for instance, the Second Amendment, have greater value than, say, that of the First or the Tenth Amendment?
I would certainly never say that any one freedom in this country is more important than the other. We have such a wonderful process here in the United States, and we are the best country out there, and we have something very unique, which is all of our freedoms. But the NRA has a sworn duty to protect the Second Amendment, so that is our greatest interest.
Okay. I wanted to ask, too, because, and one of the reasons I think that this is hitting such a note with people, not just because it's a First Amendment issue, but also some people are citing that this is sort of a precedence with the NRA. Now, I'm looking at a letter that was sent out from the NRA July 10th, 2009, and it's not a flat-out endorsement of Harry Reid, but you say his opposition to gun bans has been consistent during his tenure in office, and you celebrate that. And I'm curious as to whether or not the NRA is going to get involved in any endorsements in the Reid Engel race, and just how do you, your perspective on that?
I certainly don't know. I don't know what the endorsement process will be like for that particular race. I also don't know. There are still a lot of votes coming up in the next couple of weeks prior to Congress going out of session, and so we can't make any kind of endorsements or grading but until all of those votes have come in, so we have a complete picture. Harry Reid has been consistent on the Second Amendment, but again, like I said, we just haven't made a decision on that at this point.
Do you have any guarantees that the Second Amendment is going to be protected even after you're agreeing to back off of the Disclose Act?
We will fight tooth and nail to make sure that Second Amendment is protected, and we have two wonderful historic decisions from the Supreme Court that will help us do that.
Yeah. I know you can understand my concern and the concern of all your members here. And like I said, I do appreciate